Karma Loop TV, there's a little internet. I'm here with Creation.
Creation.
So, wait.
No. I like it like that. I like it rough. I think we should just keep it just like
okay,
this.
Okay, we'll just keep it going. Creation likes it rough, and we're going to keep going. We're going to have a really rough interview. We might need a box. Can you slap me in the face?
Right now?
Yeah. Oh, that was weak.
I was scared. I didn't want to slap you really hard because you already made the face like that.
Well, you looked like you'd slap really hard.
See, you're already doing the face. Slap.
That was better.
That okay. wasn't that rough.
There
you
go.
I'm taking
the roughest
it soft.
Interview. The roughest interview we've ever had. You're here in New York with some big news around you right now.
Yeah.
Can we just get that out of the way? What happened?
Yeah, let's just do it. I freaking got signed to Sony Columbia, and it's crazy. I guess something like this hasn't happened in like a long time, you know, so it's shocking for everybody.
I mean, you're breaking a lot of new ground. You're a promising member of a very new group of young people coming up in hip-hop.
I love it.
I want to know, is there any details about the deal you can share?
Nothing's changing. It's not going to be like Gucci Gucci came out and then I'm doing a pop song with Lady Gaga. It's going to be like...
You wouldn't?
I would. That's the thing. See, I'm open to everything. You know what I'm saying? But I don't want someone to tell me when to do it or how to do it. You know, but I'm definitely going to be experimenting.
You got in advance, you get money, all that stuff?
Yeah, it's crazy because, like, you know, I went to the bank today to put the check in and, like, we're just having issues. And, like, you know, I had, like, $170 in my account. And, like, you know, it's crazy.
You have songs to talk about wearing thrift store clothes, stuff like that. So, are you, like, what are you going to do when you have money? Do you think you're going to start to develop, like, a materialistic side? Or
I mean, I always grew up extremely broke, so I couldn't see myself doing anything different. Maybe buying a cup of noodles instead of Top Ramen.
Nice.
Okay. You know, because it comes in the cup, a little fancy.
The clear plastic forks instead of the white ones.
Yep.
The clear, I think it's ones. Fancier, right? The clear forks.
The clear fancier. Forks are fancy.
Yeah.
I think you have to do a lot more to dye things clear. No.
Clear dye. That'd be so good. You make
clear
t-shirts.
Well, that's how they
t-shirts.
Got these chairs.
They dyed they them clear.
Yeah, they painted with clear paint.
Clear paint. That's, you know what? You need to get a car with clear paint.
Ooh.
That would be new.
That would be wet.
That would be wet.
Wet, wet.
Novelty cycles are so fast now. Is there already going to be a post-swag word? And is it wet? What's the new word? Is swag going to stay? Because there's already a swag backlash. Things on the internet are so fickle.
Yeah, I mean, swag was a whole different word when it first was being used. You know, all the older people were like, swag was that boo-boo weed that we didn't want to smoke in the 80s. We call it swag. You got that swag? Oh, gross. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But I think swag is more than just like the style of dressing. It's like, you know, well, essence.
Philosophical,
I can't help it.
I think.
Yeah, I can't help it. Like somebody will hand you something and you'll be like, swag. You know, it's like a way of saying for show. But, you know, there's going to be new words. But I think swag is definitely, I can't stop it. I've sat and I've tried to think of words that I can replace it with, but I can't. Swag.
So at this point, it's too important to just be like a trend slang word. It's transcended. It's solidified its place in history.
I think it has.
I mean, I think it has.
I think it has, definitely.